masterpiece made an impression as soon as I was able to purchase a bottle, and it was one of the most exotic fragrances that I was able to obtain. A few words come to mind when I think of this fragrance. Dark, yet bright. Sexy, exotic, and like nothing else you may have in your stash, but followed by another word, which is expensive. This is not a cheap fragrance, so your boy is here to offer you an alternative if you want to save a couple of dollars to, I don't know, buy another 86 rolls of toilet paper that will burn your asshole like sandpaper, maybe another 16 bottles of hand sanitizer that are diluted with water because dudes are selling them on eBay like that, or you're just buying gallons of Everclear to sanitize everything that's around you. Let's roll my motherfucking music so I can show you this alternative to this gorgeous fragrance, and you can save a buck or two trying to save yourself from this fucking pandemic. We're all alone in the villa. We may hear the friends on the south side. In case you cared, out of all your friends, I wanna be Cuba. Bless your morning, my beautiful peoples. You know who it is. This is your boy, C to the U to the B to the A. The glorious fragrance that once I got my nose on it, it was love at first sniff, is none other than by the House of Memo, and that's African Leather. African Leather might be one of those fragrances that you never thought that you would truly enjoy in your stash, or maybe it's just a scent profile that you've never gotten your fucking nose on ever. But it's also in the 200 plus vibe. You might find this secondhand for around the 180, 190 mark. Just be careful because there's a lot of fakes out there. I've even gotten caught with one early on. Oh, but times have changed. This particular one is absolutely epic. Beautiful masterpiece blended with so many different layers, and the way that it develops on my skin is magical. So I'm bringing you an alternative if you want to save a little bread, and the fragrance is none other than Duos Cuir de Africano. Now, cuir means leather, not what you think, you nasty little fuck. These fragrances, right from jump, I'm gonna be honest with you, they are about 90% close, with the first round win going to Memo's African Leather. Now, I have these two fragrances sprayed on test strips, and they've dried down already. This one is the Memo, and this one is the Duo. And I'm gonna keep it 1,000 with you. Memo definitely wins on the opening. The leather component is bright, right from the opening with the Memo African Leather, all the way from the opening to the dry down, where the Duo one really starts shining and really the similarities start becoming clear on mid and towards the end of mid to the full dry down, where you get that 90 to 94% of the closeness. But on the opening, the magic definitely happens from Memo right from jump. If you're not familiar with these fragrances, they encompass a beautiful leathery, spicy bergamot, saffron, cumin, oud, musky darkness. You feel like you're in the middle of Nigeria getting ready to fucking massacre some lions and shit while wearing a three-piece suit because you're luxurious like that. Damn, that makes you sound kind of like a fucking poacher. Never mind, disregard that analogy. Now, these have been sprayed on the test strip already, so these are the points where they smell super similar, like very, very fucking similar. But I can distinguish which one is the authentic Memo and which one is the inspired interpretation or the fucking clone. Yeah, on the Memo, the spiciness and that saffron quality is definitely brighter and a little bit spicier. Although on the Duo one, it's a little bit more subdued and maybe slightly more wearable. And for some reason, I'm picking up a little bit of a dry, dark, chocolatey nuance on both fragrances, which I don't know where it's developing from, but that's what I'm getting as far as my snoop is concerned. But yeah, they're super, again, 90 to 94% close. If you got that kind of coin, you could definitely go after and pursue the original because it's absolutely gorgeous. But if you want a cheaper alternative, and I know they're dropping some coupon this weekend or next weekend, this is definitely the essence that you want at a more affordable price point. You're not getting 100% of the scent profile of this fragrance, but you're getting, again, 90 to 94%. It's just such an ill fragrance and something that's so left from everything else that you may have in your stash that just brings this breath of fresh air to the fucking vibe. Like, sometimes just the redundancy of this whole fragrance journey is just boring or whack, or just the comparisons to this, this, and that just gets stupid. Like, if you want something exotic, dark, leathery, spicy, bright, and a little bit chocolatey with some mystery behind it, Memo African Leather or Cuir de Africano will definitely quench that exotic thirst. In my opinion, both of them are ball sprayers, so I'm gonna spray them both on my testicles equally. Excuse me, double barrel trigger nuts. Oh, that shit just made it a little extra fucking potent. Ooh, that might have been too much. Yo, if you want to get the alternative Cuir de Africano, I'll leave a link below. Your decision. I love y'all motherfuckers from the heart, and I'll see y'all bitches next time. You know who it is. The biggest safari elephant rider in the game, kid. Smooches. Cubano. What's fresh? Who's best? One of them's gonna
pass the test. But the fly gun holder, money folder, Motorola star tack when it's time to call back. For the rough, rugged, and raw way, this nigga Jay, it's a game, but he don't play. Ay. For all the chicks that got dead in the penthouse suite on top of my mom's crib. It's nonsense you never get in. It's nonsense that you would think that you would.